In this video, we are going to review the methodology of gateway cloning. Gateway cloning is based on the site-specific recombination machinery used by phage lambda to integrate its genome into E. coli. The phage lambda, in an attempt to outwit the restriction enzyme defense of E. coli, evolved a lysogenic pathway. In this situation, the phage uses site-specific recombination to integrate itself into the bacterial genome and hide from the restriction enzyme defense. The enzymes used by phage lambda to integrate and later excise itself are the basis of gateway cloning. In this diagram, you can see that the integration system involves specific DNA sequences found on the phage at P sites, as well as sites found on the bacterial genomic target at B. Recombination between the B and P elements results in new recombination sequences flanking the inserted phage DNA. After insertion, the recombination sequences are now called at L and at R. If the phage senses that the bacteria is under stress, it will excise itself. Upon excision, at L and at R are converted back to at P and at B, and the phage DNA is removed from the bacterial chromosome. Since gateway cloning is moving elements from one plasmid to another, they do not refer to integration and excision, but rather the BP reaction, going from BP to LR sites, and the LR reaction, going from LR to BP sites. These two recombination events are perpetually reversible. Gateway cloning is built on a series of plasmids called entry vectors and destination vectors. Entry vectors are used to capture a gene or gene fragment of interest to create an entry clone. When performing gateway cloning, you will create one or more entry clone. 1 to 4 entry clones can be introduced into a destination vector. The outcome is your desired expression clone. The system is designed to allow you to rapidly and easily rearrange multiple entry clones without the need to reclone the actual insert. Once you have your entry clone or clones, you need to create your expression clones. You will choose the appropriate destination vector. Destination vectors are engineered to accommodate everything from mammalian expression to two hybrid screening. The identical LR reaction is used no matter which expression clone you are building. Gateway technology also allows you to combine multiple entry clones into a single expression vector in one step. Pros and cons of gateway cloning are summarized here. Gateway is fast. The BP and LR reactions are considered complete in 5 minutes. In addition, the entire system relies on only 2 enzyme mixtures. This makes the system very high throughput. One entry clone can easily be adapted by transferring to different destination vectors. There is no need for repeat sequencing. Gateway makes multiple fragment assembly easy. The first and most obvious con of gateway cloning is that it inevitably leaves scars. Extra care must be given to storage and handling of the reagents. In principle, the gateway cloning reactions are not subject to background. In reality, there is a risk of background colony growth if the CCDB survival gene acquires enough mutations. The gateway cloning vectors and the associated BP and LR clonase enzyme mixtures are relatively expensive. The entire system is proprietary to the Invitrogen arm of Thermo Fisher, and there is no direct competitor on the market. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.